So you've signed up for your first or maybe your 100th triathlon. Unfortunately, you've had no practice in the pool or open water due to various pool closures, maybe due to weather. For whatever reason, you weren't able to prepare as well as you thought you would be able to in the water. Today I wanted to share with you four things you can do to prepare yourself for your first open water swim of the season, and it has nothing to do with swimming. Number one, investing in the right equipment. And this has to do with knowing the water temperature. So the most important thing you're gonna wanna invest in when you're preparing for open water swimming is a wetsuit. There's three types of wetsuits. The first one is called a core short. I'm gonna wear this if it's above 70 degrees and below the limit of 76.1, because if it's above 76.1, wetsuits are not allowed. So I'm gonna wear this between 70 and 76.1 degrees. The second one is long legs, short sleeves. I'm gonna wear this type of wetsuit generally if the water temperature is between 65 and 70. And if it's below 65, unless it's a sprint or an Olympic, I'm gonna wear a long sleeve, long leg wetsuit. So it's important to invest in a wetsuit. The second piece of equipment you're gonna wanna invest in is goggles. I suggest you invest in kind of a lighter color goggle and a darker color goggle, depending on where the sun is shining that morning. You're gonna kind of be able to choose the right goggles for the venue. The second thing you can do to prepare for your upcoming event is knowing the course. How big is the open water swimming venue? How many buoys are there gonna be? What are the ins and outs? Where do you enter the water? Where do you exit the water? Is the race director gonna allow in the water warm up, or are you gonna have to practice a warm up out of the water? I've created two videos that help you acclimate to cold water and what to do in the water for your warm up. And I've created another video of some dry land exercises you can do to warm up. That's something you could practice, at least the dry land exercises, as a pre-race warm up in case the venue doesn't allow in the water warm up. You're also gonna wanna practice sighting. You can easily get your mind set on how to sight by practicing alligator eyes in front of your mirror. I've done a video on alligator eyes, but generally when you sight, you wanna lift your nose up, you wanna lift your eyes up to the goggle line while you exhale out your nose. You're gonna sight and then breathe. Just knowing the mechanics of sighting first and then breathing, if you can practice that, great in open water, but if you can't, as long as you know the mechanics of sighting, you're gonna be well ahead of people who don't. You're also gonna wanna know what it feels like to swim with other people. Again, you're not able to practice that, but if someone tells you what to expect, there's gonna be bodies around, you might get kicked, you might get someone to put their hand kind of over you while they're taking the stroke. No one means to go over you. No one means to push you under the water. That may or may not happen. So having a pre-race plan is going to help you decide where you're going to start. If you're like me, I'm always going to start my wave front and center if it's a wave start. If it's a time trial start, I'm still gonna start in the front, but I'm not concerned of being the actual first person. I'd rather start a few behind so I can try to draft off someone else. But going back to that wave start, if you're a weaker swimmer, a less experienced swimmer, you wanna have a pre-race plan of knowing the course, knowing if you're gonna go clockwise or counterclockwise, and how you're going to line up. If it's a mass start, if it's a wave start, or if it's a rolling start, you want to have that pre-race plan ahead of time of how and when you're going to start your open water swim. So there you have it. Having the right equipment, knowing the water temperature, knowing the course ins and outs, knowing the start format, knowing generally how to sight, and I've created a whole video about how to sight in open water, and just having a little bit of a pre-race plan about how you personally are gonna go about starting yourself is going to help you gain a little bit of relaxation, a little bit of confidence, that despite not being able to practice in the water to prepare yourself, you're still going to be as prepared as you can. And if you believe you can or believe you can't, you're right.